Hello, my name is Stefan Wiesner. I'm a photographer based in Bern, Switzerland. This is part one of a two-part series about high-speed flash with cheap flashes and with more expensive flashes, but with speed lights. I have here a Yongnuo 563. They are about 60 bucks. And it shouldn't matter which flash you have. This should work with any speed light. It shouldn't matter which one it is. It can be cheap, it can be expensive, it doesn't really matter. I have here the Sony A7 II. Again, it doesn't matter, it should work with every camera that can, where you can attach a trigger. And I have a cheap Yongnuo 603, the second version with the buttons on the side here. And this trigger and this flash don't have high-speed synchronization. I will make another video about this, but this one, it's cheap, it doesn't have any high-speed stuff at all. So if you take a photo without any high-speed equipment and you go too fast with your shutter speed, like usually above 200s or 250s, then you get the shutter in the picture, so it gets black, you know, on the bottom or on the whole picture, depending on which speed you have. So you can't take pictures with more than, say, 250s. Mm-hmm. But there's always a trick. Speed lights have a very short time to burn. It's very short. So if you have the shutter open for, say, 100s, the flash is much shorter. So a lot of the time, when the shutter is still open, there will be no light there from the flash, because it's so short. Okay, that's the basics. But the time it takes for the speed for the speed light to be on depends on the power. So if you turn down the power, the flash duration is different, and we can use this. I have a Küchenmixer, a multi-mix, and the blades are turning fast. So if I take a photo with, say, without flash, say F6 and 200s, and it turns, the picture will be blurry. Yeah, the blades will be blurry because of the motion, because 200s isn't fast enough, right? But if I use a flash kind of freezes the action, right? We know this, but not always, and we will see this in a minute. So I have the flash on full power. I turn on the flash, I put the Sony on 200s, F14 with ISO 100, and I turn it on and I take a picture, and first without flash to show you how it looks, then with flash, and we have the light from the flash. The flash should freeze the action, but it won't, on full power. So, like I said, the blades are still blurry despite using the flash, despite the supposedly short duration of the flash. But if you turn down the flash, if you go to, say, a force, and I go here from F14 to, say, F9, and we try again, then the blades are not really frozen, but much sharper already on 1/4. And if I go to 1/8 or 1/16, then they are sharp. Yeah? They are tech sharp. And so that is a way to take high-speed photography without any special equipment, with cheap flashes, but you can't use them on full power. So you might need several flashes, and then it gets expensive again. But if you have several of those, or you can borrow them from your friends or whatever, you can do it. Yeah? And it doesn't sound like a lot of power, but if you are indoor, two flashes on 1/16 is a lot of power indoor. Depending if you put a softbox or whatever on it, you will lose light. And remember, you will lose light if you move the flash farther away. But if you do like water drops, you can do water drops with those flashes. If you do indoor sport where you can get very close. You might use those, you might need two or three, but you get three of those for one young Nuo that is high speed capable. So again, it might be a trade-off, and the trigger is much cheaper, and depending on your camera might or might not support high speed synchronization and so on. Not all cameras can do that. So this should work with any camera. It's a very important lesson. I really encourage you to try it out. Try it out. Yeah. Get a feel for it. Get a feel for it, how this works and how fast or how much power you can use to still freeze the action. That depends, of course, on the action. The blades are turning very fast. A human being that is just running won't be that fast, for example. But you need to move farther away. You don't have that much power. Yeah. Always a trade-off. In photography, it's always a trade-off. With enough money and with enough effort, you can do anything. But usually, we neither have the time nor the money. So we have to make compromises. Okay? And in the second part, we'll take a look at high-speed flash. So, see you in a minute.